puzzled today on what to preach.
I love that.
And I'm telling y'all, Pastor Mike, y'all better pray for real, because I have no notes.
Oh, I love that.
I didn't write nothing down. I have nothing in my iPad.
I love it.
But this word. So y'all better pray that I get up the hill and roll down. But I do have something to say, I think. And if y'all pray with me, we're going to get on out of here on tonight. Matthew chapter 26. It is very significant that this is a men's conference and it's Good Friday.
Yes.
That was very significant to me that she put this same conference on Good Friday. I want to read, for the sake of time, I'm not going to read all of these verses, but I want to read verse number 39 and skip down to verse 42. Matthew 26, verse 39 and verse 42. Verse 39 says, and he went a little further and fell on his face and prayed, saying, O my Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as thou wilt. Verse 42.
Yes, sir.
He went away again the second time and prayed, saying, O my Father, this cup may not pass away from me except I drink it. Thy will be done. Let's go up to the verse number 36 that says, then cometh Jesus with them unto a place called Gethsemane. Said unto the disciples, sit ye here while I go and pray yonder.
Yes, sir.
Thank God for reading those words and a blessing to our souls. On tonight, I want to talk about a fight in Gethsemane. A fight in Gethsemane.
Preacher.
I will start off by suggesting to you and y'all help me up the hill on this one. I will start off by suggesting to you, whether saved or filled with the Holy Ghost or not, you're going to go through a fight. You're going to go through something. And to be honest and quite frank, I must tag with my sister prophetess Terry Raven when I say it seems like the fight is more intense in the kingdom than in the world. And I guess really based on the perspective of how we see the world and how we see God. Because can't no loving God allow certain things to happen to you if he loves us the way he says? This is coming from the top of my head now, so y'all better pray. It will change your perspective by God because of him being sovereign and what he allows to happen in our lives. And it only makes us better, not bitter. It only creates us to be stronger, not weaker. It only creates us to understand him more and get closer to him. But the truth of the matter is, all of us have a fight. Wish I had somebody to help me up here. The truth of the matter is, all of us have a fight. And of course, when connecting to the kingdom of God, it was sometimes after we said yes to God that the fight in intensified.
Yes, that's right.
Sometimes after you said yes to God, that you began to understand really who God really is. The fight intensified. Matter of fact, sometimes some of us would question, if we would be honest and truthful, if we were saved or not.
Let's be honest.
They ain't helping me, Caleb. They looking at me crazy. But the truth of the matter is, some of us would question if we have the Holy Ghost or not. Because can't nothing be that intense and God love us that much? I'm trying, y'all. Can't nothing be that intense and God love us that much. But God shows us that regardless of what we face, regardless of what we fight with, I did not invest all of this on the inside of you so you can wimp out. I did not invest all of this on the inside of you so you can punk out. I did not invest all of this on the inside of you so you can say, I quit, I give up, I throw in the towel. But I invested that you utilize what's on the inside of you. Lord, help me in here. And there is a fight that we have to face on a consistent basis. And to be honest, it's not external. It's really in your mind. I feel preached already. It's really in your mind. It is interesting. Job suggested like this: a man who's born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. Oh, Lord, help me in this place today. And the truth is, we don't physically fight what we're surrounded by, but we have to go through a spiritual battle.
Yes.
My God.
And this is what makes it intense, and this is what makes it challenging, because I'm used to fighting stuff physically.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not used to fighting stuff I can't see. I'm used to telling people off in front of their face. I'm not used to praying about it. I'm used to cussing them out. I'm not used to this is a fight I'm not used to. This is a more mental battle than physical. And I wish I had somebody around us that be going through a fight while I'm here. Anybody, what you say, anybody who has a ministry, anybody who has an anointing, anybody who has the power of God in their life, you go through a consistent fight. The devil don't let up. He consistently attacks. He consistently going. I wish you to high five your neighbor real quick and say, neighbor, he's talking to me. Because matter of fact, just this past week, I had to go through something just today. I had to deal with some stuff. Just last night I had to deal with. This is why my press is not for show. Lord, help me, Lord. My pressing and my pushing and my praise and my worship is not to cause people or to get the attention of people. I'm doing it because if it hadn't been for God keeping my mind, I probably would have went crazy. I'm doing it because if it hadn't been for God keeping me together, I probably would have lost my mind long time. I wish you would do something for me. Your neighbor and said, neighbor, God kept me together. It wasn't you, it wasn't Pastor Boone, it wasn't Prophet Israel, it wasn't Prophet Taylor, it wasn't Pastor Carter. God kept me together. He's keeping me together right now. He's keeping me together right now. And the battle is, sometimes what God says doesn't match with our position. Help me in the Holy Ghost. I feel. What God says, He told me I'm the head and not the tail. He told me I'm above and not beneath. He told me I'm the lender and not the borrower. Why am I struggling? Why am I going through? Why are people walking away? Why are folk talking about me like a dog when I am genuine and I give and I support and I push and I do I'm getting. Sometimes you end up like Jeremiah. I ain't saying nothing. I'm going to lay in the bed and just sleep. I'm not even going to get up and go to church. I'm not saying nothing else about you anymore. Because every time I open my mouth, I end up in trouble. Every time I open my mouth, I end up in prison. Every time I open my mouth, I end up in a pit. I'm not saying.
My God.
I'm not saying nothing. One man who knows about a battle. Is Jesus.
Yes, my God.
Who understands this battle, this fight, is Jesus. If any man can talk about going through a fight,
my God,
it's Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Here it is, y'all. The fight ain't Judas betraying him. The fight ain't Peter denying it.
My God.
The fight ain't even the people wanting him crucified.
Wow.
The fight is with him. Fight is with his
My God.
You will never see nowhere, even in this text, verse 39 and even 42, that he was fighting with an enemy. He wasn't even fighting with the devil. He was fighting with himself.
My God.
Lord, help me. I'm helping somebody. I'm helping somebody. Because the fact of the matter is, a lot of us are anointed, and we don't know how to deal with the anointing that's on our lives. Because it's a change. We all put a roller coaster. We up one day, and we're down the next. And it's not because of something we did. It's because of the anointing. We can't do nothing about it. Wish I had somebody to help me in this church. We can't do nothing about it. We just got to face it and deal with it. That's why it's important, if you are connected to a person who's anointed, you need to encourage that person more than ever, because you don't know what that person is going through. You don't know what, I know I ain't got no help with you. You don't know what that person is dealing with. You don't know what the attack on that person's life that's in their mind.
Yeah.
I ain't fighting with you, I'm fighting with me.
Yeah.
I'm not fighting with going on. I care less if you talk about me. I care less if you. I wish I had some help with you. I care less if you lie on me. I care less if you put it out there on Facebook that I'm messing around. It don't even matter with me. I'm fighting with me.
My God.
My God.
My
God.
I'm struggling with myself.
My God.
I'm struggling with humanity and divinity. I'm struggling with reality and anointing. I'm struggling with battle. Jesus goes through. Now you must discover that Jesus says this, Father. If you be willing, take this cup. All right. Now some of y'all are so deep. You're so anointed to where you don't feel nothing. Everything in your life is a bed of roses. But if anybody could understand what we as people go through, it would be Jesus. Jesus said in the text, Father, if you are willing,
my God,
take this. Here it is. In our turn, I don't want this. All right. Because the truth of the matter is, Pastor Carter, there are some things we don't want. All right. Yeah. I don't want this assignment, but I'm obligated to the assignment. No. Wish I had somebody to help me. I don't want this. I'm obligated to this.
All right.
Father, if anybody can take this, it would be you, God. Father, if you're willing, take this cup.
My God.
We today call this day Good Friday, but for Jesus, it wasn't good at all.
My God.
For Jesus, it wasn't good at all. Father, if you need, and this is why I don't understand why the church have made days like this entertainment more than what it is really about. We have church going through 2 and 3, 7 last words, and it's all foolishness. I've never seen it before in my life. You trying to do this and do that and preach so you can get another engagement and get another post and get people to like you and get people to support you. You want to be in front. You want to be on the spotlight. You want folk to look at you, and you want to have your picture on a flyer. I got so sick today of looking at photos and flyers. I got so sick. I just got off Facebook. I got off Instagram because I got so sick of looking at foolishness. Because if you really knew what Jesus went through. You would be trying to entertain people.
Yes, I
do. I don't know what Jesus went through.
That's right. Jesus.
You wear a robe and a collar.
All right.
My God.
You self look big in front of folk.
Yes.
My God.
And don't understand what he went through.
All right. My God.
We quote it and look at it, but we really. We preach it, but we really. Because this wasn't when he was crucified, Pastor Carter.
That's right.
My God.
This was at the Garden of Gethsemane. Yes. He wasn't crucified yet.
That's right.
Come on, church. He wasn't crucified yet.
My God.
Right.
But he was having a problem, a battle
right.
with him.
My God.
Help me in the Holy Ghost. I wish you would high five your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm about to overcome this battle. I don't know who I'm talking to in here. I don't know who I'm preaching to in here. There's been a battle that you've been facing as an anointed man and woman of God. But I came to tell you tonight, you're about to overcome. I wish you would shake off your church, y'all. I wish you would shake the neighbor's hand and say, neighbor, you're about to overcome. You're about to overcome. The devil is alive. You will not lose your mind. You will not upbraid it. You will not turn the tide. You will not turn the tide. Put your hands somebody to follow your neighbor and say, get ready to overcome. Get ready to overcome. Get ready to overcome. And hey, coming to everybody. That's why a lot of people. Robert Spencer couldn't be here because we don't need entertainers. We need glory carriers. Lord, help your butt. We don't need people that's going to push us and tickle our fancy. We need people that's going to destroy some yokes. We need people that's going to deliver somebody. Shake your neighbor. Say, that's the name that you have to come out of this, right? Father,
yes.
If you be willing, take this cup.
Yes.
First verse, 39, colon, nevertheless. Nevertheless, it is, my purpose is greater than this pain.
All right, my God.
That's number 1 point. My purpose is greater that in this pain. One thing, and this is even attached to what Prophetess Raven said, the one thing she said, that even when she was being real on the stage or on platform, the one thing she said, I know my assignment is great. Well, Misty, even though I'm dealing with what I'm dealing with, the one thing I do know that my assignment is great, because the enemy don't attack people without great assignments. I wish I had somebody in here that would pull on your neighbor and say, neighbor, that's why the devil fighting you. That's why the devil is torturing you. That's why the devil trying to attack your family. That's why the devil trying to hit your family. Because your assignment is great.
My God.
It wouldn't attack you.
Oh my God.
Your assignment.
Yes.
Yes.
I wish you would high five your neighbor real quick and say, neighbor, my assignment is great. That's why you cannot pull out. You got to stay in. You cannot throw in the towel. You got to keep pushing. I don't care how you feel. This is not based on your emotions. Lord, help me in here. This is based on how you feel. This is based on what's on your life.
Yes.
My God.
Yes.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Purpose is greater than the pain. Then, if you understand, the word Gethsemane.
Uh-huh.
Gethsemane means pressing.
Pressing.
And notice in that season, when he was praying, he was sweating and great drops of blood.
My God.
What's coming out of him? Why? Because God is trying to say, even in your season of pain, I'm pulling the anointing out of you. Lord, help me. It is when an olive has to be crushed in order for the oil to come out. You thinking this pressing is killing you? It ain't killing you. It's pulling the oil. Wish I had a church in here that would shake your neighbor's hand and say, neighbor, this thing ain't killing you. It's pulling the oil out of you. And the more you get pressed, the greater. Because I've been going through hell myself, and I don't need about five people to shout oil coming out of me. Oil coming. I need about five people to shout oil coming out of me. I'm gonna get back up and I'm gonna sing like I never sung before. Not my will.
My Lord.
Your will.
Yes, sir.
Number two, there's a plan in the process.
My God.
Number two, there's a plan in the process. Because one thing God never does, He never allows you to go through anything and not sustain you. He never allows you to go through anything and not sustain you while you're in it. And then He never allows you to go through anything and not cause victory in your life after you have gone through. That's why Paul says, after you suffer a while, Lord, let me in here. If you suffer with Him, you shall rest. I ain't got no church in here. I wish you would pull somebody in here and say, neighbor, I suffer long enough. Victory is about to take place. I can't tell you who they is, or you might go get them. I see you on every flyer. I see you. I see you doing this. And I see you doing that. And I'm trying to wonder how in the world you're doing it. Can you hook me up?
Oh, no.
So they inbox the right one. Because I'm crazy. After the pulpit, you don't bother me. I'm crazy now. So I told him, I said, well, lose a house, lose a couple of cars, lose your job, have your own family talk against your ministry, and then you're able to come in my position. Until then, you ain't able. I wish I had somebody to look at your neighbor and say, if you knew what I've been through, you will understand my home. If you knew what I suffered with, you won't understand why God has blessed. I don't know my story. I have somebody to shake your neighbor's hand and say, neighbor, if you only knew my story, if you only knew the nights I had to cry, if you only knew the nights I struggled, if you only knew. Yeah.
Mama.
Not only.
Yes. My God.
He has a plan in the process.
Yes.
Purpose for the pain.
Mama.
But He has given Jesus power to endure for the promise.
My God.
Notice He says it not once, but what? Mess me up because He said this twice.
My God.
In between what He was saying, He went to His disciples and said, y'all sleep. If I wanted to work this, Mike, I could work this. He said, y'all sleep. I'm over here fighting with what I got to encounter. And y'all sleep. I give myself to you.
God.
You were around me the whole time. And then I told you the assignment that's on my life. So if anybody needs to be awake, it should be the people close. But y'all
sleep.
He says this, Anthony, and then he walks away. Because now I know I got to deal with this. Come on, Caleb. By myself. But if I don't have nobody with me, I know who is. Father, I swear. I feel the Holy Ghost in here. My hand. I wish you would pull up somebody and say, neighbor, if I ain't got nobody helping me, if everybody walks away from my ministry, if everybody walks away from my vision, there's still one who got my back. I wish you would pull up somebody and say, neighbor, you got power over me. You got power over me. And the more you begin to do it, the more you have power. I'm done, y'all. Thank you, Prince. Shake your neighbor's head one more time. It was confusing to me. I looked at the adapter. I looked at my phone. It was in the socket. And I said, why isn't it charging? I didn't understand. I'm like, everything is connected. Everything is intact. But it's still not charging. And so when we was actually in Rochester, so when the pastor came up to my room, I said, Pastor, he said, we got a problem. And he said, what's wrong, man? I said, my phone is dead. And my phone had most of my, I'm talking about everything, my Bible, everything on it. And so I said, my phone is dead and I need my phone. He says, okay, he looked, he said, okay, it's in the socket, it's in the, he said, I don't understand what's wrong. Now, if I don't understand what's wrong, you don't understand what's wrong, we in trouble. So his wife comes up. And I said, we're just trying to put it on different sockets. It still wouldn't come on. She said, hold on, y'all. Have you turned on the power switch? We looked at each other and said, oh, Lord. We didn't understand that in order for the phone to be charged, even through the socket, the power switch.
Okay.
Lord,
help me over here. And nothing can come on or off in the power switch. And in order for that to take place, she had to turn off. I wish I had somebody in here to pull up your neighbor and say, neighbor, sources, and you ain't got to turn me on, because I got power in me. Yeah. You need to pull on some y'all and put it, pull on somebody else and say, neighbor, I got power in me, and whatever you need in your life, God will move for you. I dare you to touch at least three people. And y'all ain't with me, but I feel the Holy Ghost. I feel the Holy Ghost in here to grab one person and say, neighbor, I believe if we praise God together, by the time we get home, something will shift in our lives. But what about two or three that gather together? He's not in the midst. So I get somebody to praise right now. Open up your mouth and shout in this place right now. Come on, let me hear you. People are funny and finicky. So they will never determine if you're in God's will. Whether you have 3 or 3,000, people will never determine. What determines you're in God's will is the fight. God, I feel the Holy Ghost in here. I need everybody to lift their hands and worship. Because God says the more intense the fight is, the more he's going to show his glory in your life. And this next season is going to be a change season for you. Why, Pastor Boone, is it going to be a change season? Because God has to distance some leeches. There are people that are attached to you who want spotlight so bad to where they will destroy your ministry. You don't know it, but there's some who are talking right now behind your back, destroying your name to make themselves look good. And I decree and declare, touch her right now, that that season is over and done with. You will live free and at peace in the name of Red God. To come out of this. God says in this next season, I'm going to give you a plan. I'm going to give you a strategy, and I'm going to move on your behalf right now. I don't need nobody to entertain. I want somebody to open up your mouth, because we, I wish I had somebody in here to open up your mouth right now. Come on, come on. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Come on, come on. In the name of Jesus, and the weapon that's formed against you shall be able to prosper. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Listen, I want you to connect with somebody. I want you to connect with somebody. I want you to connect with somebody. Grab somebody. Grab somebody. I don't care who it is. Grab somebody. Grab somebody. Prophet Israel, can you come up here? Come on, come on. Thank you.
Lord told me to tell you, prophetess, do not be surprised. Do not be shocked over this season in your life. There have been people who have been plotting. There have been people who have been plotting. And they are people who you would not believe. Praying against you. And there are some who will not believe. But the one thing that God will not allow, He will not allow you to go down.
Thank you, God.
I wish I had somebody to help me. He will not allow you to go down. He might allow you to be hit, but He will not allow you to go down. And Pastor Teresa, I want you to touch her. I want you to touch her. Because the Lord says there is going to be a release, a fresh, a new, a fresh. And I want somebody in here to open up your mouth and hold the Lord God. A fresh, new, fresh, new. That's why the attack has been more intense than ever. Because there got to be something fresh coming out of this. There got to be something new coming out of this. There got to be something fresh coming out of this. I hear this in the spirit realm, but don't have the Holy Ghost. I want you to run up here right now. We got some preachers right here ready. I don't care if you're young, old, middle aged, child, it don't matter. The Lord just told me there's some people in here who need the Holy Ghost. Come on, run up here right now. Now, one thing I will do, and that is call you out if you don't come. Feel the spirit of the Lord in this place. Listen, everybody just lift your hands. I'm almost there. Listen, princess, I want you to do something for me. Can you do something for me real quick? I want you to come up here. You, come here. You, yeah, come on. I want you to touch him. Touch your son. Because the power of the Holy Ghost that's on the inside of you is about to heal him. The power and the Holy Ghost that's on the inside of you is going to heal him. I need some anesthesia. Y'all looking. I need some prayer just to open up your mouth. This battle is over. I mean, church, this battle is over. This battle is over. This battle is over. This battle is over. I feel it. I wish I had somebody who had the Holy Ghost on the inside of you to open up your mouth. This battle. Come on, it's warfare here. This is warfare here. Because this is not, this is a spirit that knocks you out. And the devil is in fire. Do what you asked me long time ago, a while back. want you to close your eyes.
Thank you, God.
Come on.
Thank you, God.
I don't know if any of y'all, because I'm so old school. I am so old school. I was raised by my grandmother and my parents, so I am so old school. And I was raised where they called Jesus until you felt me. We got a couple of witnesses out there who, you know what I'm talking about, who didn't get up from the altar. And I don't know, but I feel that has to take place for you to feel the power of God, because it's on you and it's in you, but there has to come a manifestation of the power of the Holy Ghost. So I just want you to call Jesus as loud as you can, and we're going to help you tonight, because we're going to push you to feel the power and the Holy Ghost. Come on, I want somebody to help me call Jesus. Come on, come on.
Come on.
say breakthrough is about to happen now. But God said, if you shout for it, God said, it's going to happen before you leave this place. Now, one thing I do not do, I don't give babies. I don't give up. Oh, that ain't me. But I heard the Lord say, it'll happen right now based on your praise. And I want you to praise God for everything you got tonight. If you're going to give God every person, give God a praise right now.